The topic for our mutual encouragement this afternoon is from zero to zero.
今天下午也与大家彼此勉励的题目是从零至零。
Let's first turn to Bible.
我们来看圣经。
Job chapter 1.
约伯记的第一章。
Job chapter 1 verse 21.
一章的二十一节。约伯记的一章的二十一节，二十一节。说我出生出于母胎，也必出生归回。赏赐的是耶和华，收取的也是耶和华。耶和华的名是应当称颂的。
We know the background of Job.
我们知道约伯的背景。
Was that he suffered attacks of the Satan?
那他受到了就是撒旦的攻击。
In one day, his ten children died in a tragedy.
那在一天同一天呢，他的十个儿女就在一次的这个意外当中给去世了。
Whilst they were actually feasting in the oldest brother's house,
就在他们在就是长子的家还在享用这个宴席的时候就死了。
Means they were taken away in the pain of their health. They were taken away in the pain of their health. 他们很健康的时候，
就是他们在很健康的时候就离世了。
Also on the same day, Job lost all his possessions.
那同样在一天，约伯也失去了他所一切的财物。
And this includes his sheep, camels, oxen, donkeys, and servants.
那包括他的一切的牲畜、驴、羊、牛，以及他的仆人。
Verse 20 tells us that when Job heard of this bad news,
二十节告诉我们，当他听见这个噩耗的时候
，Job arose, tore his robe, shaved his head.
他便起来撕裂外袍，剃了头。
All this action tells us of his great grief.
那这举动告诉我们他极大的悲伤。
But at the same time, he fell down on the ground and worshipped God.
那在同时呢，他俯伏在地上，并且敬拜神。
Verse 21 that we have read and are discussing today.
那我们要刚刚读的二十一节，就是我们今天要讨论的。
Is actually the contents of his worship.
就是他崇拜的内容。
These words were spoken in a prayer in a very delicate situation.
那这是在非常这极端的情况下所做出的祷告。
And these words reveals the true intent and true thoughts and intents of Job's heart.
那这就显露出他内心最真实的想法。
Verse 21, Job said.
二十一节，约伯说。
Naked I came from my mother's womb.
我赤身出于母胎
，and naked shall I return back，
也必赤身归回。
Job tells us that when we came into the world，
约伯告诉我们，当我们来到这个世界的时候
，we came without any possessions，
我们来的时候并不带任何的财物。
We know that when we were born，
我们知道当我们出生的时候
，we brought nothing with us，
我们并不带着任何的东西来
，not even our clothes，
连身上的衣服也没有。
Job also points out that one day we will depart from this world.
约伯也说我们有一天会离开这个世界。
And no matter how much possessions we have amassed for ourselves in this world,
那这个世界上不管我们积累了多少的财富
we cannot bring them together with us.
我们不能够把他们带走。
We shall leave empty-handed.
我们会赤身的归回。
Naked I came from my mother's womb, and naked shall I return there.
我赤身出于母胎，也必赤身归回。
We started our life with zero, and we will end our life with zero.
我们从零来到这个世界上，我们离开的时候也是带着零离开的。
This is a reality of life.
这就是生命的真相。
And I have and this is also the concept of life that Job has.
这也是约伯对人生所有的观念。
And this is a concept that I have turned this concept from zero to zero.
因此我就把这个称为这个从零至零。
And this is also the title of my sharing this afternoon.
这也是我今天下午与大家彼此勉励的题目。
For our sharing, we shall understand further from the Bible to understand the concept of life and how it applies to our life.
那我们从圣经当中来了解，并且更了解我们这一生。
First, from zero to zero tells us that since we have came into the world with zero,
从零至零告诉我们，首先我们是赤身来到这个世界
，and that we will depart from this world with zero.
那我们也会赤身的归回。
Therefore, whatever possessions that we have amassed are blessings from God.
所以我们所在这辈子所累积的财物，其实是神给我们的福气。
Do you agree with this?
对这一点你是否同意呢
？Before we were born.
在我们还未诞生之前
，whatever toys, clothes, strollers that our parents have prepared for us.
我们父母给我们预备的衣服、玩具以及这个推车子
，they do not belong to us.
都不属于我们的。
Only when we came into this world,
只有当我们来到了这个世界
，these became our possessions.
这才成了我们的我们的财物。
So we came with zero, we came with nothing.
我们来的时候是不带着任何东西来。
Only when we are born into this world, when we have a status in this world.We possess these things.
只有当我们来到这个世界了，我们在这里有了我们的身份，我们才拥有这一切。
Similarly, as we grow up, the items that we accumulated.
同样的，当我们离开的时候，我们所积累的一切。
As we grow up, the items that we accumulated.
当我们长大之后，我们所积累的一切。
The assets that we own.
我们所拥有的资产。
Or the things that have been given to us.
或者是赐予我们的一切东西。
These are items. These may be items that we personally work hard for.
可能是我们努力而得到的一些东西。
Or items that we have paid for with our own money.
或者是我们用我们自己的钱所购买的。
But it was God that has given us life.
但是是神把生命赐给我们。
God has given us health and ability and chance to have all these things.
神赐给我们健康，赐给我们机会，让我们拥有这一切。
Which is why Job says that it's God who gives.
因此约伯说赏赐的是耶和华。
The preacher in Ecclesiastes also agreed with what Job said.
那在传道人在传道书也同意约伯所说的话。
Let's turn to Ecclesiastes chapter 5.
我们看传道书的五章。
Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 18 to verse 19.
传道书的五章十八到十九节。传道书五章十八十九节十八节。我所见为善为美的，就是人在神赐他一生的日子吃喝，享受日光之下劳碌得来的好处，因为这是他的份。神赐人资财丰富，使他能以吃用，能取自己的份，在他劳碌中喜乐，这乃是神的恩赐。
The preacher says that God has given riches and wealth to man.
传道人说神赐人资财丰富。
And he has given him power to eat of it.
也是给他这权柄。
To receive his heritage and rejoice in his labor.
那在他劳碌之下能够享受这些好处。
This is the gift of God.
这是神赐给人的福气。
Today, when we look at the possessions that we have,
今天我们看看我们所拥有的资产。
When we look at our family members, our health, and our ability to enjoy all this food and entertainment.
当我们看见我们的家人、我们的财物，并且我们有这个有能力来享受这一切。
When we still have the strength and opportunity to work and to enjoy the fruits of our labor.
我们还有时间，还有力量来享受我们日光之下所劳碌得来的好处。
Let us not forget God.
让我们别忘了神。
Instead, let us be all the more thankful to the providence of God in our life.
相反的，我们更应该感激神给我们的供给。
Sometimes in life is very ironical.
有时候生命是非常矛盾的。
When we have nothing, we pray to God, we are close to God, we draw near to God.
当我们什么都没有的时候，我们向神祷告，我们亲近神。
But when we have amassed something for ourselves,
当我们已经积累了一些财富之后
，When our life become more comfortable, more affluent,
当我们的生活变得越来越舒适的时候
，Yet we forget about this God that has blessed us.
我们却忘了赐给我们福气的神。
Let us remember that all these things that we have amassed for ourselves are blessings from God.
让我们记得我们所积累到的这些财物都是神赐给我们的福气。
Second, from zero to zero tells us that our God is a sovereign.
那第二点关于这从零至零告诉我们就是神是至大的。
He has the authority to determine when we come into the world.
他有绝对的权利来决定我们什么时候来到这个世界。
And when we will depart from this world.
并且我们什么时候会离开这个世界
？He has the authority to determine the length of our stay and the boundary of our stay.
他有权柄来限定我们所居住的年日以及所居住的疆界。
He has the authority to determine what he wants to give to us and when he wants to give it to us.
那他有这个权柄来决定要赐给我们什么以及什么时候赐给我们。
Similarly, he has the authority to determine when he wants to take back from us.
同样的，他也有这个权柄来决定什么时候要把这一切从我们身上给夺去。
And whether he want to take back all the blessings from us.
他是否要把所有的这些福气都从我们身上都给收去呢？
We can turn back to Job chapter 1 verse 21.
我们可以看约伯记的一章二十一节。
Job says that God has given.
约伯说，赏赐的是耶和华。
God has taken back.
收取的也是耶和华。
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
耶和华的名是应当称颂的。
Why was Job still able to worship and praise God amidst his grief?
即便是他在极大的悲苦当中，为什么约伯还是可以敬拜神，仍然可以称颂神呢？
Why was Job still able to praise God in the midst of his troubles and sufferings?
那在他的受苦患难当中，为什么他还可以来颂赞神呢？
Job understood that since we came in the world with zero.
约伯了解，既然我们是次生出于母胎
来到世界。One day we will leave the world with zero.
我们也会不带走一切离开世界。
Therefore, all the blessings that we have are given by God.
因此，我们所得到的一切的福气都来自于神。
Since God have the sovereignty to give us these blessings.
因为神有这个权柄来赐给我们这些福气。
God has the authority also to take away all these things from us.
那自然的，神也有权柄把我们身上这些福气都给收回去。
Whilst we have blessings from God,
我们既然有神的的恩典，
we have enjoyed them and were grateful for them.
我们享受了并且也感恩。
Why then should we not be grateful when all these things have been taken away from us?
但是当这些从我们身上被夺去的时候，为什么我们也不心存感谢呢？
When we have been given a chance to enjoy all these things.
当我们有机会来享受这一切的时候，
Today do we have the same understanding of sovereignty of God?
关于神的独权的权柄，我们是否有这个了解呢？
If we have the right understanding of the sovereignty,
如果我们对神绝对的权柄有了解的话，
Not only will we not murmur and blame God when we meet with death, illness, or difficulties in our life.
那在我们面对到生病或者是不如意的事，甚至是死亡的时候，我们就不会埋怨神。
On the other hand, we'll thank God for good times that we have had.
相反的，我们会因为我们所经历过的这些好的时光而感谢神。
And to continue to trust and rely on this sovereignty.In the times of our sufferings,
相反的，在我们在遭受苦难的日子的时候，继续相信神绝对的权柄。
For us Christians, God being the sovereign in our life also teaches us that God has His will and purpose for each of our lives.
那这也让我们相信神在我们身上都有他的旨意。
Now let's turn to Ecclesiastes.
我们来看传道书。
Ecclesiastes chapter 3.
传道书的三章。
Verse 1.
三章一节，传道书三章一节，凡事都有定期，天下万物都有定时。
Verse 11，
十一节，三章十一节，神造万物各按其时成为美好，又将永生安置在人心里。然而神从始至终的作为，人不能渗透。
These verses tells us that God has His own purpose and His own will.
这里告诉我们，神有他的旨意。
He will make everything beautiful in His time.
神将按个其实成为美好。
Yes, just like Job.
像约伯一样。
There will be times when we will meet with the crisis of our life.
有一些时候是我们必须面对我们一些危机的。
There will be times when wave and wave of trouble will beset us.
有一些时候是我们会碰见许多的困难。
There will be times when we'll be emotionally challenged and drained and we want to give up.
甚至是一些非常难熬的时刻，是让我们几乎要放弃的感觉。
At such time, let us not forget that God has His will and His purpose.
那当碰到这些事情的时候，我们别忘了神有他的旨意以及他的时间。
He has His reasons as to why He allowed us to go through these times.
那他有他的原因，为什么让我们遭遇到这一切的苦难呢？
Let us continue to put our faith and trust in the Lord of ours.
让我们继续相信并且信靠我们的神。
For he has promised that he will make all things beautiful in his time.
因为他应许会各按其时让所有事情成为美好。
Job walked through the crisis of his life.
那约伯就目睹了他生命中的这些危机。
In the midst of the crisis, he had many questions in his heart.
在他面对这些苦难的时候，他心中有许多的问号。
But at the end, Job gained a deeper knowledge of God.
那最终他对神有了更深一层的认识。
Job said, "I have heard of you by the hearing of my ear."
那约伯说，我曾经风闻有你。
But now my eyes see you.
现在我亲眼看见你。
Likewise, another Bible character, Joseph.
同样的另外一个圣经的人物约瑟。
When he walked through the crisis of his life.
当他经历了人生的苦难。
He made this statement that God meant it for good.
那他就说了这句话是神让一切都变美好。
神的旨意原是好的。
神的旨意原是好的。
Let us also have faith that God has a beautiful will and purpose for us as we go through crises and difficulties in our life.
让我们记得，当我们在经历人生的苦难的时候，神有他美好的旨意。
Third, from zero to zero tells us that we are just only custodian of our worldly possessions.
那从零至零也告诉我们，我们只是这世上所有的财物的管家。
Custodian means that the worldly possessions actually belong to God.
那管家的意思就是说我们世上的一些财物都是属于神的。
We are just people managing the monies temporarily.
我们只是暂时管理这些钱财而已。
As we live on this earth.
当我们离开世界。
Just as we begin our journey with zero.
就好像我们从零开始我们的人生。
There will be a day that we reach a stage where we will have zero.
那总有一天我们也会回到零。
Therefore, whatever that is really given to us by God is for use when we are on this earth.
那神所赐给我们的一切只是在我们这世上所使用而已。
One day, this will no longer belong to us.
有一天这些都不再属于我们。
One day, we will have no use of all these things.
有一天我们将不会再使用到这一些。
Therefore, other than enjoying these blessings that have been given to us,
因此，与其在享受我们所得到的这些这些东西
，Let us also think of how we ought to use all these possessions that we have to serve God。
我们应该仔细的想一想，我们该怎么善用这些所得到的这些财物来服侍神。
Let us turn to the Bible, First Chronicles。
我们来看历代志上。
First Chronicles。
历代志上。
Chapter 29。
二十九章。
Verse 12。
二十九章十二节，历代志上二十九章十二节，丰富尊荣都从你而来，你也治理万物，在你手里大有能有大能大力，使人尊大强盛都出于你。十四节，我算什么？我的名算什么？竟能如此乐意奉献，因为万物都从你而来，我们把从你而得的献给你。
These were the words of David when they gathered the materials and offered them up for building of the temple.
这是大卫在准备建殿所需要的材料的时候所说的话。
Verse 12, David knew that it was God that has given the riches.
那十二节，大卫知道是神把这些丰富都赐给他们了。
And when they offer to the building of the temple, they are just giving back to God what belonged to God.
所以当他们把这些都奉献给神的时候，只是把属于神的东西奉献给神而已。
In other words, God is a source of our material riches.
也就是说，关于我们所拥有的这些属世的这些财物，都是属于神的。
And we are just custodian.
我们只是他们这些财物的管家。
And when we offer to God.
当我们献给神的时候。
When we serve God with our worldly possessions.
当我们用我们属世的这些财物奉献给神的时候
，We are actually just giving back to God what originally belongs to God。
我们只是把原来就属于神的东西奉献给神。
Paul also have this similar concept。
保罗也有同样的观念。
Let's turn to First Timothy chapter 6。
我们看提摩太前书的六章。
First Timothy chapter 6。
提摩太前书的六章
，verse 17 to verse 19，
十七到十九节。提摩太前书六章十七到十九节，十七节，你要嘱咐那些今世富足的人，不要自高，也不要依靠无定的钱财，只要依靠那赐后赐百物给我们享受的神。又要嘱咐他们行善，好在好事上富足，甘心施舍，乐意供给人，为自己织成美好的根基，预备将来，叫他们持定那真正的生命。
This is the instructions of Paul to Timothy.
这是保罗对提摩太的嘱咐。
And of course, during that time, Timothy was a preacher. He was also pastoring some of the churches.
那当时提摩太也是一个传道人，他也在注目一些教会。
Paul asked Timothy to command those who are rich not to be haughty or trust in uncertain riches.
那他就要让提摩太去嘱咐那些富足的人，不要自高，也不要依靠无定的钱财。
Instead, the rich should trust in the living God, who is the source of the riches.
相反的，这些富足的人应该要依靠那厚赐百物给我们享受的神。
Verse 18, Paul encouraged those who have been entrusted with the riches to do good, ready to give, willing to share.
同时也要嘱咐他们要行善，在好事上富足，甘心的施舍。
We thank our loving God that many of us have been blessed with abundance in terms of worldly possessions.
那我们感谢神，我们大部分人从这属世的财物来说，都从神那里蒙了极大的福气。
But as we receive these blessings and grace of God,
在我们从神那里领受到这些福气及恩典的同时
，Let us consider that we are just custodian of these possessions.
让我们别忘了，我们只是这些财物的管家而已。
Other than enjoying what God has given to us,
除了享受神所赐给我们的一切
，Let us also be resolved to use them to serve the real owner of the possessions.
让我们也立志来侍奉就是这些财物真正的主人。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 25.
我们看马太福音书的二十五章。
Matthew chapter 25.
马太福音书的二十五章。
Verse 14 to verse 13.
十四到三十节。
Matthew 25 verse 14 to verse 30。
马太福音书二十五章十四到三十节。十四节，天国又好比一个人要往外国去，就叫了仆人来，把他的家业给他们，按着他们个人的才干给他们银子，一个给了五千，一个给了二千，一个给了一千，就往外国去了。那领五千的随即拿去做买卖，另外赚了五千；那领二千的也照样另赚了二千。但那领一千的去掘开地，把主人的银子埋藏了。过了许久，那些仆人的主人来了，和他们算账。那领五千银子的又带来另外的五千，说：“主啊，你交给的五千银子，请看，我又赚了五千。”主人说：“好，你这良善又忠心的仆人，你在不多的事上有忠心，我要把许多事派你管理，你可以进来享受你主人的快乐。”那领二千的也来说：“主啊，你交给我的二千银子，请看。”我又赚了两千。主人说：“好，你这良善又忠心的仆人，你在不多的事上有忠心，我要把许多事派你管理，可以进来享受你主人的快乐。”那领一千的也来说：“主啊，我知道你是忍心的人，没有种的地方要收割，没有善的地方要聚敛，我就害怕去把你的一千银子埋藏在地里，请看你的原银子在这里。”主人回答说：“你这又饿又懒的仆人，你既知道我没有种的地方要收割，没有善的地方要聚敛，就当把我的银子放给兑换银钱的人，等我来的时候可以连本带利收回，夺过他的钱来给那有一万的，因为凡有的还要嫁给他，叫他有余，没有的连他所有的也要夺过来，把这无用的仆人丢到外面黑暗里，在那里必要哀哭切齿了。”
This is the parable of talents spoken by Jesus.
这是主耶稣说的才干的比喻。
Jesus actually spoke this parable to teach us how to prepare for his second coming.
他教导我们这个比喻是让我们知道如何预备他的第二次的再来。
In this parable, the master was traveling to a far country.
在这个比喻当中，这个主人要到外国去。
And he delivered his goods to his servant.
他就把家业交给他的仆人。
In the essence of the master, the servants were the custodian of the monies that were given to them.
那这个主人不在的时候这些仆人就成了这些家业的管家。
The master gave five talents to one.
那他就把五千银子给了其中一个仆人。
To another, to another one.
另外一个给了两千，另外一个给了一千。
Please take note that this was given according to their own abilities.
请注意，这是根据他们的能力所分配的。
We know that subsequently, the one with five talents traded and made another five talents.
我们知道后来这领了五千的，他就去做了买卖，另外赚了五千。
The one with two traded and gained another two.
那领二千的也照样领了另外赚了二千。
But the one with one hid his talent in the ground.
那么领一千的却把银子埋藏在地里。
Verse 19 tells us, after a long time, the master returned and settled the accounts with the servants.
19节告诉我们，过了许久，那些仆人的主人来了，和他们算账。
The two servants who used master's talents to trade were and gained more talents were praised and rewarded by the master.
那两个把用银子去做买卖，另外再赚了银子的这两个仆人，就得到了主人的称赞。
The servant who hid the talent in the ground was rebuked as a wicked and lazy servant.
那把银子埋藏在地里的，却被主人骂说是又饿又懒的仆人。
And the unprofitable servant was cast out into outer darkness.
那这又饿又懒的仆人却被丢到黑暗里。
Today, similar to these three servants.
今天同样的关于这三个仆人。
We are also the custodian of God's money.
关于神的钱财，我们也是这管家而已。
One day, we will have to give account to our God, our Master.
有一天，我们也要向神来交账的。
No matter whether we have been given 5 talents, 2 talents, or 1 talent.
就不管我们是领五千的、领二千的，还是领一千的。
Let us use these riches that we have to serve God willingly.
让我们甘心乐意的来奉献，来侍奉我们的主。
Let us turn to 1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 7.
我们看提摩太前书六章。
First Timothy chapter 6 verse 7.
六章七节，提摩太前书六章七节。六章七节，因为我们没有带什么来到世上，也不能带什么去。
The last point I want to share this afternoon.
今天下午要分享的。
From zero to zero tells us that one day our life on earth will come to an end.
从零至零也告诉我们，我们世上的这个生命也会来到一个结束。
All things that we have amassed cannot be taken away by us.
我们所积累的一切都不能够带走。
When we pass from this world,
当我们离开了这个世界，
these possessions, has nothing to do with us any longer.
那我们所拥有的这些财物和我们就无关系了。
It can at most be given to our future generations to enjoy.
那顶多只能够留给我们下一代去享用。
But really, our lives on earth need not just be from zero to zero.
那其实我们的生命不只是其实不只是从零至零而已。
Our life on earth can be from zero to infinity.
其实我们的生命可以是从零至无限的。
God has promised us life eternal.
因为神已经给我们应许永生。
A life with our infinite God forever in His kingdom.
就是我们永远都在他的国度里。
Have we used this from zero to zero life of ours to gain the real riches of life?
那我们是否用这个从零至零的这个生命来取得这永生呢？真正的财富呢
？To exchange it for eternal life.
用它来换永生呢？
Only when we have exchanged our riches on earth, for eternal life.
只有我们把世上的财物来与永生来交换的话
，can our life be zero to infinity?
那这样我们的生命才能够从零变成无限。
First Timothy chapter 6 verse 17 to 19.
提摩太前书六章十七到十九节。
First Timothy chapter 6 verse 17 to 19.
提摩太前书六章十七到十九节，十七节。你要嘱咐那些今世富足的人，不要自高，也不要依靠无定的钱财，只要依靠那后赐百物给我们享受的神。又要嘱咐他们行善，在好事上富足，甘心施舍，乐意供给人，为自己积成美好的根基，预备将来叫他们持定那真正的生命。
Here Paul tells us that when we use our physical riches in this world to serve God,
保罗告诉我们，如果我们用这世上的财物来侍奉神。
We will store up for ourselves a good foundation for the time to come.
我们是为自己积成美好的根基，预备将来。
And that we can lay hold on eternal life.
这样我们就是持定那真正的生命。
Jesus also tells us the same thing.
耶稣也是告诉我们同样的事情。
Let's turn to Matthew chapter 6.
我们看马太福音书的六章。
Matthew chapter 6 verse 19 to 21.
六章十九到二十一节。六章十九到二十一节，十九节，不要为自己积攒财宝在地上，地上有虫子咬，能朽坏，也有贼挖窟窿来偷。只要积攒财宝在天上，天上没有虫子咬，不能朽坏，也没有贼挖窟窿来偷。因为你的财宝在哪里，你的心也在那里。
Jesus encouraged us not to lay up for ourselves treasures on earth.
耶稣勉励我们不要为自己积攒财宝在地上,
but to lay up for ourselves treasures in heaven.
而是在天上积攒我们的财宝。
Today, you and I who are in True Jesus Church are truly blessed.
今天在真耶稣教会的你我是真正的蒙福了。
We have come to know the true God.
我们已经来到认识真神。
We have entered into Christ's kingdom.
我们已经进入了基督的国度。
And we have this living hope that one day when we depart from this earthly tents of ours,
就是以前我们离开这个世界的时候,
when we end our journey on earth,
我们结束了今生的旅途,
we can return to our heavenly home to be with our Lord Jesus forever.
我们可以回到天国与耶稣基督永远的同住。
As such, whilst we live on earth, whilst we lead a life from zero to zero,
因此我们活在世界上，我们在过着从零至零的生活的时候，
let us not forget to exchange our life from zero to zero with a life that is zero to infinity.
让我们别忘了用这个从零至零的生命，与从零至无限的永生的生命来做交换。
Let us lead a life that allow us to make the infinity sure.
那让我们过着，我们以后过的生命必须要确定我们的。 所得到的永生是确定的。
The Bible teaches us that we should work out our salvation with fear and trembling.
圣经告诉我们必须要战战兢兢地来做成我们得救的功夫。
And we need to do this by keeping ourselves in the church that saves.
我们必须要把守自己在得救的教会里。
We need to keep ourselves in the Lord, in our Lord Jesus Christ.
我们必须要保守自己在主耶稣基督里。
We need to build up a personal relationship with our Lord Jesus.
我们与耶稣基督必须要建立好我们个人的关系。
We need to lead a life that is obedient to the teachings and commandments of our infinite God.
我们必须要顺服我们无限主的一切的律例以及遵守他的诫命。
We need to fulfill the commission that Jesus has entrusted to us on this earth.
我们必须要就是完成耶稣基督所托付给我们的使命。
To preach the gospel, to take care of our brethren.
来传扬福音，并且来照顾我们的同龄。
If we are able to do all these things,
如果我们可以做这一些事情的话,
we are storing up treasures for ourselves in heaven.
那我们就是在天上积攒我们的财宝。
We are making our salvation sure.
我们是在让我们的得救得到一个确定。
From zero to zero,
从零至零。
This was the Job's concept towards life on earth.
这是约伯在世上的一个观念。
And towards the possessions that he have.
以及对他所拥有的这些财物的观念。
As a result, Job continued to hold fast to God in times of deep loss, extreme difficulties, and the crisis of his life.
因此在面临人生的苦难以及失去一切东西之后，他还是能够紧紧地握着神。
Despite the heavy hand that was dealt to him, he was still able to continue to worship and praise God.
即便是他遭受的极大的苦难，他还是可以敬拜神，他还是可以称颂神。
From zero to zero should also be a concept that Christians have towards our life.
从零至零也是我们基督徒对生命的一个观念。
And towards the possessions that we have.
以及对我们所拥有的财物。
Since we have come into the world with zero,
既然我们带着零来到世界,
one fine day we will depart with zero.
有一天我们会带着零离开。
Let us be thankful for things that we possess.
让我们为我们所拥有的财物来感恩。
For these are the blessings from God.
因为这一切都是神的福气。
Let us truly know that our God is the sovereign.
让我们认知神绝对的权柄。
And he is the Lord of our life.
他是我们生命的主。
The Lord has given, the Lord can take away.
赏赐在主，主也可以收取。
And the Lord has a higher purpose and will for us.
主有给我们更高的旨意以及目的。
Let us be also aware that we are just the custodian of the possessions that we have accumulated on earth.
我们要意识到我们只是在关于我们世上所累积到的这些财物，我们只是管家而已。
And the real owner is God.
那真正的主人是神。
There will come a day where we need to account for all these possessions.
那有一天我们对我们所拥有的这一切，我们要做一个交账。
Let us not only use these possessions on ourselves,
让我们不要只是只把这些财物用在我们自己身上。
Let us use these possessions to serve God, to love our brethren.
让我们用这些财物来侍奉神，来爱我们的弟兄。
Let us be that profitable servant and not unprofitable one.
让我们成为这良善的仆人，而不是那个又恶又懒的仆人。
Let us use our life and possessions to truly exchange for infinity.
让我们用我们的生命以及我们的财物来交换得到永生。
While our physical life on earth is from zero to zero.
我们世上的生命是从零至零。
Our spiritual life need not be from zero to zero.
我们的灵命不应该是从零至零的。
Let us make use of this futile life of ours to grab hold of eternity.
让我们用这短暂的生命来交换永生。
May God continue to lead us unto eternity.
祈求神带领我们进入永生。
Let us sing our closing hymn.
我们再唱结束的诗歌。
Hymn 521.